have gathered to celebrate their commencement. All are in their places. The ceremony you are about to see extends a tradition that is nearly 1,000 years old. The academic rest and ritual have their origins in the first English universities of the Middle Ages. The mace is a symbol of the university. The robes you wear reflects our medieval past, and the caps and tassels are ancient symbols. But the attire you wear is also a symbol of the outstanding achievements that have brought you to this moment. Aim with vision, skill, and knowledge, you now face a future full of possibility and success. While today is one of joy and celebration, the commencement ceremony itself calls for dignity and decorum. This is one of the greatest days of a lifetime for our graduates, their families, and their friends. Therefore, we request everyone's cooperation in according this ceremony the quiet respect it deserves. These exercises for spring 2021 are hereby called to order.
Thank you, Dr. Antree. I'm John Nason, Chancellor of Penn State Harrisburg, and I welcome you to commencement today. Although the pandemic has required us to make some noticeable changes to our ceremony, we are delighted to be able to gather in person and individually recognize our spring 2021 graduates. Please join together in singing a national anthem led by Shannon Dinner, who is a sophomore student at Penn State Harrisburg. Thank you all. Please be seated. It's my pleasure, and I would like to recognize members of the platform party. starting with Dr. Amid Ansari, our Senior Associate Dean for Academic Affairs and Administration, who bore the mace for today's ceremony. Dr. Holly Angelique, Assistant Dean for Academic Affairs. Dr. Piriduwu, Assistant Dean for Graduate Studies. Dr. Todd Clark, Senior Director of Student Services. Professor Hanelair, Lecturer in English Composition. Dr. Mark Kaselica, Director of the School of Behavioral Sciences and Education. Dr. Stephen Shapey, Director, School of Business Administration. Dr. Jeffrey Beck, Director, School of Humanities. Dr. Marvin Overby, Director, School of Public Affairs. Dr. Thang Bui, Associate Director, School of Science, Engineering, and Technology. And Dr. Glenn McEwen, Director, Penn State Harrisburg Library. Please join me in recognizing the individuals of our platform party. It now gives me great pleasure to introduce our keynote speaker, Dr. Catherine Sando. Dr. Sando is a business strategist, consultant, entrepreneur, educator, and community leader. For nearly 20 years, she has been a local trailblazer in communications, public relations, and education disciplines. In her professional role as head of communications and public affairs at the Lancaster County Solid Waste Management Authority, she has served in various leadership and executive capacities, helping to guide the organization through critical business decisions, advancing various projects and initiatives that impacts its brand and its reputation. She's also known in the academic space through her role as an adjunct lecturer at Penn State Harrisburg, facilitating knowledge and discovery with students in the communications program, and continuing her research on how to leverage media and pop culture to initiate social change. Katie is also a writer, speaker, and workshop facilitator with a personal mission to inspire others to activate their purpose and champion the advancement of women and girls. She lives out this calling through her professional and academic endeavors, but also through her philanthropic efforts. She serves on the Board of Trustees for Lancaster Chamber and Board of Directors for Girls on the Run, Lancaster, Lebanon, and the YWCA in Lancaster. She's previously served on the International Board for Solid Waste Association of North America, the Board of Directors for Lancaster Housing Opportunity Partnership, and on the advisory board for the Harrisburg Area Community College campus, the Lancaster campus. Katie is one of our own, having earned a master's in arts and communications from Penn State Harrisburg, and a doctor of education in adult education, also from Penn State Harrisburg. She currently serves on the advisory board of Penn State Harrisburg School of Humanities. Katie was also honored with Penn State Harrisburg 2020 People to Watch Award for her impact to the betterment of society, along with Central Pennsylvania Business Journal's 2019 Women of Influence Award for her contributions to company, industry, and community. She's been recognized for her academic work at Penn State Harrisburg, having received the 2017 Learned Society of Whispering Pines Graduate Student Award in Adult Education, and the 2015 Catherine Towns Award. Please join me in welcoming Katie to be our commencement speaker this evening. Katie?
Class of 2021. I want you to soak in this moment. I want this night to be forever burned into your memory because you are on the precipice of greatness. This, my friends, is a seminal moment, a defining time in your life. Not because you're celebrating the degree that you worked so hard for, but because you have a choice to make tonight. A choice whether or not you will live a life of greatness. See, my role on the stage is not to give you advice on how to be successful, because frankly, none of us have figured life out. But I will share with you one thing I know to be true, the one thing I want you to take away from my words tonight, and that is what it takes to live a life of greatness. By greatness, I don't mean fame or fortune. While that may be the destiny for some of you, those things should not be your aim. By greatness, I mean fulfilling the purpose that you were uniquely created for. See, I believe God created each of us for a purpose, and life's great adventure is to discover and grow into that calling. It's a journey to follow your soul's path into the mist of the unknown future, to go where you can't see what lies ahead, but you walk forth boldly towards the calling meant uniquely for you. And my friends, when you discover your purpose, it surges forth like the fierce sun burning away the morning fog, burning away all of the noise, the clutter, distractions, and emptiness of an ordinary life. When you decide to walk this purpose path, you will live a life that shines brightly to all those around you, and you will change the world, even if that world is for just one person. Sadly, most people wait too long to follow their calling, and others never do. But my hope is that you make a choice to live a life of purpose and join the change makers of this world. But know this too, living a life of purpose is not always a glorious journey. It is not for the faint of heart, nor for those looking for the highs of more money, more promotions, more power, more things, more. No, this life of purpose is a beautiful and a hard one, full of transformative experiences, discoveries, pain, joy, and becomings. And as you follow your purpose, you will fail. We all fail, and let no one have you think otherwise. But in the words of Theodore Roosevelt, he says, "It is not the critic who counts, not the man who points out how the strong man stumbles, or where the doer of deeds could have done them better. The credit belongs to the man who is actually in the arena, whose face is marred by dust and sweat and blood, who strives valiantly, who errs and comes short again and again. Because there is no effort without error and shortcoming. But who does actually strive to do the deeds, who knows great enthusiasms, the great devotions, who spends himself in a worthy cause, who at the best knows in the end the triumph of high achievement, and who at the worst, if he fails, at least fails while daring greatly, so that his place shall never be with those cold and timid souls who know neither victory nor defeat." And why am I talking about failure on such a special night? Because as much as I have succeeded, and successes are what we like to talk about on nights like this, I have also failed. I want you to know I have failed hard. And you will fail too. But know this, those failures do not define you. I want you to know that in those moments of failure, when you are face down in the arena, if you have the anchor of purpose, you will find the courage to be both disappointed and brave. You will find the strength to rise and try again, because these times of struggle shape you for your purpose. Know this also, as you follow your purpose, you will succeed and experience overwhelming joy. And when those moments come, I hope you remember that they are not just the result of your own doing, but because people have loved you and lifted you and given you the chance to shine brightly. Remember that, so you too can give others the chance to shine brightly. They need your light and encouragement, and sharing it will take nothing away from your own brilliance. So how does any of this relate to tonight? Well, all of these experiences, the failures and successes, point to one thing: the opportunity to harness our unique energy and gifts into a force for good, despite what life brings our way. This is what purpose does. And in the words of Glennon Doyle, she says, each of us was born to bring forth something that has never existed. We are here to fully introduce ourselves, to impose ourselves and ideas and thoughts and dreams onto the world, leaving it changed forever by who we are and what we bring forth from our depths. This is purpose. You see, my friends, greatness is not solely measured by what you do or what you achieve, but by who you become and touch along the way. It's about learning from your experiences and using that wisdom and love to help others, because we have one beautiful life. And the people who live with purpose are the ones who live an extraordinary life, a life of deep fulfillment. So tonight is a seminal moment. You have a choice to make when you walk out of the doors of this auditorium, a choice of whether you will live a life of purpose, a life of greatness. So feel this moment deeply. Feel it on your skin, the energy of the room, the feeling of the regalia as it rests on your body and asks you to make a choice. Feel this moment in your lungs. Breathe in the significance of this day and the strength within you as it asks you to make a choice. Feel this moment in your heart, the invigorating beat of reaching this incredible milestone, knowing not what lies ahead of you, but that something is calling to you. And feel this moment in your bones, knowing you have a choice whether to leave an ordinary life or an extraordinary life. You know the answer in your bones. Feel it deeply, my friends. You were made for greatness, and I hope you live it. Congratulations.
Thank you, Dr. Soundo, for your sharing your thoughts with us today and your continued contributions to Penn State Harrisburg. Katie, thank you very much. One of the most valued assets of Penn State Harrisburg is its prestigious Board of Advisors, a distinguished group of area business, government, and community leaders who provide a liaison between the college and the community. In the 3 years that I've been able to return back to Penn State Harrisburg, even though about half of that time has now been done up with COVID issues. The Board of Advisors has worked with us in many different ways to maintain engagement with our faculty, staff, and students, and trying their best to make sure that Penn State Harrisburg continues to advance into the future. The Board of Advisors is chaired by Lisa Taroshi, the Vice President of Clinical and Support Services at Country Meadows Retirement Communities. We'll be hearing from her today via a recorded greeting.
Hello, everyone. I'm pleased to join you today. On behalf of the Penn State Harrisburg Board of Advisors, I congratulate today's graduates and wish you all great success in your future endeavors. Recent times have been very challenging, and you rose to the occasion. Congratulations on achieving this successful accomplishment. The Penn State Harrisburg Board of Advisors is a group of dedicated community volunteers who support the development of the college. The board consults with and advises the chancellor of the college on policies relating to matters of programming, financing, and community outreach, assists in linking the college with businesses, government, alumni, and the community, raises funds and acquires gifts for the improvement of the physical plant, instructional needs, scholarships, and academic services of the college, and undertakes other activities in support of the college as may become desirable. There are 29 esteemed regular members appointed by the president of the university, 11 honorary members, and 12 ex officio members who labor tirelessly on behalf of the college. Together, we are committed to Penn State's mission of teaching, research, and service as we strive to make life better in our great commonwealth. Again, congratulations to you on your graduation.
And a virtual thank you to Lisa. At this time, I'm pleased to introduce Barkava Matupalia, President of the College's Student Government Association, who will make remarks to this graduating class.
Thank you, Dr. Mason. Class of 2021, we're here. Today, you will receive the degree of which you've worked tirelessly, and tomorrow, you will step into the world and lead the charge in changing society with every decision you make. Although I can go on about honesty, integrity, etc., that most commencement speeches are about, I will speak to something different today, and special to this occasion and to this class. Perseverance. If there has been one thing that we have learned during our journey together through the pandemic, it is that perseverance will prevail. This pandemic has challenged our world in ways we could have never fathomed. It has challenged us students at an even greater level. So many struggles, hardships, and losses to where we are today. But here you are, ready to move forward, victorious. You stayed strong and persevered. So hold those heads high, Penn Staters. Every single one of you. When the odds were stacked against you, you kept fighting and progressing forward. You never gave up. You kept sight of the light at the end of the tunnel. Every single one of you are leaders stepping into this new world that needs guiding and innovative hands to adapt to what comes next. Courageous leaders who are willing to evolve the world and society through your resolute spirits. Today, you have proven to yourselves and to everyone around that you are the strongest they come. You have faced challenges that few have faced before. I myself look up to every one of you as I plan to be where you are in 2 years' time. You, class of 2021, are role models for so many of us. Perseverance. You showed us what that really means. Each of you. Each of you have accomplished so much at Penn State. And now it is time to show the world. I, along with the Penn State community, am proud of all of you, and we will be there cheering you on. So go and show the world what you're made of and lead us into the future. Thank you and congratulations once again, class of 2021. We are
Penn State. Thank you, Bhagava. I now invite Dr. Angelique to the podium for the recognition of meritorious achievements.
Thank you, Dr. Mason. Every commencement ceremony features a very special recognition of students who have taken full advantage of the educational and research opportunities at the college. We begin by recognizing the student marshals representing the academic schools and graduate studies. These students are selected based on their GPAs from among eligible students eligible to graduate. Other criteria include engagement with the academic school and the college, involvement in research and leadership activities, and faculty recommendations. Today, I would like to recognize the following student marshal who is with us today from the School of Behavioral Sciences and Education, Morgan Mayers. Please stand up, Morgan. Congratulations on your selection and recognition as a student marshal. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I ask you to turn to page 10 of the printed program where graduates' names are listed for meritorious achievement. These are students graduating in the top 12% of their class. Upon completion of the grades for this semester, additional names will be added to this list. Diplomas will have this academic achievement noted on the official document. Students who are graduating summa cum laude wear a blue and white cord. Students who are graduating magna cum laude wear a blue cord. And students who are graduating cum laude wear a white cord. Will those students graduating summa cum laude please rise and remain standing? Will those students graduating magna cum laude please rise and remain standing? And now, will those graduating cum laude please rise? Congratulations and best wishes for your continuing excellence. And I see a dog has also graduated with us today. Penn State recognizes those who have honorably served or are currently serving in the United States Armed Forces by awarding priority registration and a red, white, and blue honor cord at graduation in recognition of their duty and sacrifice. I would like to invite our graduating students who are military veterans currently serving on active duty in the Reserve or National Guard, or who will be granted a commission obtained through the Penn State Reserve Officers Training Corps, to rise and be recognized. Thank you for your service and congratulations to all of you. Now, will all of those guests in the audience who are veterans or active duty members of the military please stand? Thank you for joining me in thanking them for their significant contributions to our nations. Thank you again, and you may all be seated.
Thank you, Dr. Angelique. We're to the point in the ceremony that you've all been waiting for, the conferring of degrees. Ladies and gentlemen, as you know, the legal corporate body of the Pennsylvania State University is its Board of Trustees. This is the body, by our charter, is given the final responsibility for governance, welfare, and all other interests pertaining to the university. By virtue of the authority vested in and approved by the Board of Trustees of Penn State University, I am authorized on behalf of the board to confer on each of these candidates the degree earned and certified by the appropriate college faculty and dean. Assisting us in awarding the undergraduate degrees today are the school directors, together with Dr. Amit Ansari, our Senior Associate Dean for Academic Affairs and Administration.
Since its creation more than 50 years ago, Penn State Harrisburg, the Capital College, has grown from a small upper division only institution and graduate center to a comprehensive four-year college and graduate school enrolling 5,000 students. The college is composed of five academic schools: School of Behavioral Sciences and Education, School of Business Administration, School of Humanities, School of Public Affairs, and School of Science, Engineering, and Technology. I now invite the directors of the schools whose commencement ceremony we celebrate today to present their undergraduate degree candidates, beginning with Dr. Mark Kaselica, Director of the School of Behavioral Sciences and Education.
Will all undergraduate degree candidates from the School of Behavioral Sciences and Education please rise and remain standing? I have the honor to present, as worthy and approved candidates for the various behavioral sciences and education degrees, those who have met the academic requirements of the university for such degrees.
I now call on Dr. Marvin Overby, Director of the School of Public Affairs.
Will all undergraduate degree candidates from the School of Public Affairs please rise and remain standing? I have the honor to present, as worthy and approved, candidates for the various public affairs degrees, those who have met the academic requirements of the university for such degrees.
Will all undergraduate degree candidates from all other Penn State colleges and campuses please rise and remain standing? I have the honor to present, as worthy and approved, candidates for the various Penn State degrees, those who have met the academic requirements of the university for such degrees.
By virtue vested in me by the Board of Trustees, I now confer upon each of you the degrees you have earned. In testimony of this, you will receive a diploma admitting you to all the privileges, honors, and responsibilities of this degree. As a symbol of degrees having been confirmed, you may now move your tassel from the right to the left. To everyone present, to everyone in virtual reality, it is my great pleasure I present to you the class of 2021. Great job. Thank you. Please be seated.
Now, like to call upon and thank our nomenclator, Professor Hannah Lehr, who will introduce individual graduates by academic school. As the candidates for each of the degree are presented, graduates are requested to rise at their seats for recognition as the nomenclator reads his or her name. Afterward, please sit down.
School of Behavioral Sciences and Education. Bachelor of Elementary Education, Major in Elementary Education. Lacey Catherine Balmer. Kirsten Marie Capella. Kylie Maria Dale. Abigail Nicole Dockery. Emily Margaret Fiebig. Olivia Yvonne Heidelmark. Riley Nicole Kiefer. Samantha Lynn Lanunziata. Kaylin Lager. Erica Lynn Lengel. Timber Rain Merriman. Taryn Renee Miller. Justin Carl Mingle. Kristen Morgan. Maya Neidig. Catherine Mackenzie June Ort. Sierra Sizer. Jordan Wagner. Bachelor of Science, Major in Human Development and Family Studies. Aaron Beeson. Munaratu Moni Bubakar. Kira Nicole Brubaker. Yasli Duran. Lindsay Marie Gavlik. Kristen Johns. Lillian Marie Malley. Alexis Jessica Moreno. Ruben Latif Ransom. Elise Stifler. Jordan Wilson. Bachelor of Science, Major in Kinesiology. Michael Aaron DeHoff. Stacia Lynn Fredericks. Andrew Michael Fritz. Caitlin Gormley. Christopher Harris. Connor Scott Kirshner. Austin Richard Kunkel. Leah Angelique Maggs. Morgan Elizabeth Mayers. Leah Pastol. Vidi Patel. Brittany Short. Bachelor of Science, Major in Psychology, Trevor Basham. Also graduating with a Bachelor of Science, Major in Sociology. Anthony Earl Brown. Takia Brown. Zachary Hambleton. Brittany Nicole Harris. Ariana Marie Johnson. Olivia Mish. Severin Joyce Nokon. Kayla Paul. Amanda Windmiller. Emily Zimmerman. Bachelor of Science, Major in Sociology, Lawrence Kostreba II. Zozan Kachuk Aydin. Amanda Marie Stein. Bachelor of Social Science, Major in Secondary Education Social Studies, Joseph Bradley. Emma Adeline Durst. Jacqueline Gallo. Lawrence Jerome Spady. School of Public Administration. Bachelor of Arts, Major in Political Science. Nameen Adhikari. Also graduating with a Bachelor of Science, Major in Criminal Justice. Sean William Gatton. Alexander Groff. Mackenzie Nicole Kuhn. Gregory Lynn Molot Jr. Hadia Niazi. Jamie Lynn Esther Amanimo. Francis Sanza. Javon Tyrone Wright. Bachelor of Science, major in Criminal Justice. Dallas Campbell Cook. Michael Joel De Leon Torres. Kaylee Skye Derrickson. Sierra Dixon. Jacob Alexander Dolman. Samuel Martin Etnoyer. Jayla Lynn. Samantha Erin Mercer. Hunter Lee Nielsen. Kimberly Ortega. Madison Noelle Urich. Also graduating with a Bachelor of Science, major in Psychology. Bachelor of Science, major in Health Policy and Administration, Evan Ardeen. Liam Basiri. Henny Lorraine Salter. Maria Seeley. Bachelor of Science, major in Public Policy, John Benjamin Brettler. Brandon Francisco Cruz. Casey Danielle Keller. Owen David Shank.
Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes the conferring of the undergraduate degrees. Let's recognize them one more time. We do need some celebrating, don't we? Those candidates who are receiving graduate degrees have been officially enrolled in the university's graduate school, which administers advanced degree programs at Penn State Harrisburg, as well as other campuses of our university. Will Peter Itawu, Assistant Dean for Graduate Studies, please come forward to present the graduate degree candidates.
Will all the candidates for graduate degrees please rise? I have the honor to present as worthy and approved candidates for the various graduate degrees, those who have met the academic requirements of the university for such degrees.
By virtue of the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees, I now confer upon each of you the degrees that you have earned. In testimony of this, you will receive a diploma admitting you to all the privileges, honors, and responsibilities of this degree. Please be seated.
Will Professor Lear please come forward to recognize the candidates for the various master's and doctoral degrees? As the candidates for each of the degrees are presented, graduates are requested to rise at their seats for recognition as the nomenclator reads his or her name. Afterwards, please sit down.
Behavioral Sciences and Education. Master of Arts, major in Applied Behavior Analysis, Ariana Lynn Grimm. Makia Marie Stocker. Master of Arts, major in Community Psychology and Social Change, Jesse Edward Goranson. Master of Education, major in Health Education, Sarah Fahad Adesiri. Charlie Musinski. Phoebe Joy West. Master of Education, major in Literacy Education, Kayleen Hackman. Courtney Elizabeth Klein. Monica Knoll. Natalie Elizabeth Kratz. Elizabeth Ann Kushnes. Jennifer Marie Rayabi. Master of Education, major in Teaching and Curriculum, Taylor O'Neill Campbell. Kristen Lynn Capian. Samantha Mary Marie Wood. Master of Education, major in Training and Development, Adam Scott White. Kelly Aline Wilson. Master of Education, major in Lifelong Learning and and Adult Education. Morgan Lee Chambers. Paige Cree Chardevoy. Kevin Chung. Brian Robert Drury. Haley Jackson Fuller. Christina Law. Max Ricardo Loudon. Kimberly Lynn Liu. James Vin Nguyen. Amanda Kate Sayer. Nathaniel Tolman. Benjamin Vittler. Doctor of Education, Major in Adult Education, Marissa Ray Gravy. Marissa's thesis title is Older Adults' Experiences, Learning, Integrating, and Adopting Smart Home Technology, a Mixed Method Study. Dissertation co-chairs, Dr. Elizabeth Tisdell and Dr. Roderick Lee. Mira Caitlin Johnson. Thesis title, Growing Roots, Rewilding Transformative Learning and Ecological Consciousness in Nature Connection. Dissertation co-chairs, Dr. Elizabeth Tisdell and Dr. Anthony Bucitelli. School of Public Affairs, Master of Arts, Major in Criminal Justice, Autumn Ann Walden. Master of Health Administration, Major in Health Administration, Ahmed Almukara. Kylie Grabowski. Aisha Khalid. Master of Public Administration, Major in Public Administration, Dakota James Kennan.
This concludes the conferring of the graduate degrees. Please join me again in recognizing the accomplishments of those students. Another of our valued constituencies is the Penn State Harrisburg Alumni Society, which will now welcome our graduating class as its newest members. We will hear from its president, Bradford Simpson, via a recorded greeting.
Thank you, Dr. Mason. On behalf of the Penn State Alumni Association, I am delighted to welcome you into one of the largest, most powerful networks on earth. Today, you join more than 700,000 proud and successful Penn State alumni who are making a difference in their communities and their professions. Many of you know what the definition of alumni is, but today I'm going to tell you what being an alumni means. The alumni title is something that you should be proud of. It is a title that has to be earned and is not easily given away. More importantly, you are about to become a Penn State Harrisburg alumni. It means that you are committed to a college and a campus that gave you real-life experiences, where professors knew your name, and where you had the opportunity to become an individual instead of being just another face in the crowd. These opportunities have set you on a path to success. I know they did for me. During this promising and challenging next year, the Alumni Society urges you to stay connected to your campus and to other Penn Staters, and we will help you do just that. Our graduation gift to you is a 1-year free membership in the Penn State Alumni Association. Your membership will keep you informed of what's happening with Penn State, provide services and benefits you need as you continue your journey, and connect you with the Alumni Association's network of more than 300 alumni groups throughout the world, including an automatic membership in the Penn State Harrisburg Alumni Society. We encourage you to return to Penn State Harrisburg for class reunions and sporting events, and remember to keep your contact information up to date. As an alumnus, you can serve as a mentor to current students in your field, and as you progress in your career, consider devoting your time to interact with our students. I say this to you as new alumni and any alumni in the audience. It gives me great pleasure to induct all graduating students into the Penn State Alumni Association. On behalf of our 174,000 members, I am thrilled to offer our sincere congratulations and to welcome you to the Pride.
We thank Brad for his volunteer efforts and his commitment to our campus and to all the alumni. I encourage you to please stay connected with Penn State University and specifically with Penn State Harrisburg. Graduate is truly a great day in central Pennsylvania. I hope you agree with me on that. You are among a special group. You know you've navigated some rigors in addition to your normal academic progress in a time like no other in almost a century. It's a time that held many unexpected challenges. You've already heard that everyone's commending you on your strength and resilience and commitment in reaching this milestone of graduation. There'll be other twists and turns and bumps in the roads, and many of them you've overcome already, some of you are yet to face. We are nonetheless pleased that you selected Penn State Harrisburg. Your presence truly has made us a stronger institution and a stronger campus. Despite the odds, Penn State Harrisburg has been able to continue to grow and achieve successes over this past year. We continued providing the learning experiences to our students in ways that were often cumbersome, at times clumsy, but most importantly, everyone did their very best. You as students, the faculty, the staff, and all the support systems that could be rendered. We tried our best also to maintain our research and scholarship. We continued the best we could with partnerships in our community, with our alumni, our friends and donors. This has been made possible because of the collective efforts of every one of you, all the faculty, all the staff, alumni, friends, and hopefully our continuing students on our campus. You are all the reason we remain steadfast in our commitment to academic excellence. We've all been inspired, hopefully you've been inspired by the teaching and learning, the creation of new knowledge, innovative ideas that were brought to you and you brought to the classroom, and hopefully the idea of service to others. Many of you provided that while you were on campus, many of you provide that to the community, and many of you will continue to do so as you go out and about in the world. You'll join thousands of Penn State alumni living and working in this region. Others will go off to destinations far and wide, I'm sure. But regardless of where you'll settle, I do remain confident you will contribute significantly to the workforce in your community. To the families, friends, and supporters of our graduates, congratulations. All of you have contributed greatly to their success. Will all the graduates please acknowledge the support that you've received from your family, friends, and supporters? To our talented faculty and staff, you've been teachers, advisors, and mentors to these graduates. Thank you. You are equal partners in today's celebration. Can we also please join me in recognizing the faculty and staff that supported all these students? Graduates, on behalf of the entire Penn State Harrisburg community, I extend best wishes for a bright and productive future. We hope you will stay in touch. We hope you will come back to visit. We hope you will continue to engage in our community and everything that we try to be, because we are. Thank you all very much. As an alum of this great campus, it is certainly my distinct pleasure that the Penn State alma mater is printed on the front cover of your commencement program. Please rise and join together in singing the alma mater led by Shannon Zinner. Afterwards, please remain standing for the recessional. One subnote, please. Graduates may meet their guests in the plaza in front of the Giant Center between the parking lots and the main entrance. Event staff will dismiss you from your seats. Thank you for continuing, all of you, everyone in this arena, for observing the social distancing requirements that have been placed upon us. Please remember those as you exit the building. I wish you the best health and safety, and I look forward to a more traditional gathering sometime in the future. Thank you for being with us today. Thank you all.